click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
So, hello friends. Culture is a pattern of taken for granted, at least in India, where we assume a lot of collection of people from different cultures having a say, different kind of expression and behavior according to their culture. We only, in our daily affairs, but this is just an assumption. Actually, we are born and brought up in a particular culture, and then we take it as, you know, we assume it as taking it up in a cultural way. So cultural diversity makes communication difficult as the mindset of the people of different cultures is different. So the way they think, their languages, their signs, their symbols, everything is different. Different cultures have different meaning of words, behaviors, and even gestures. Culture also rises up to prejudice and manners and opinions. So every person from a different culture would have a different opinion, would have different manners. When people belonging to different cultures communicate, these factors become barriers. So the factors is not the culture, the factors is the way a person is born and brought up, the way they are given cultures, the different signs, the different manners, opinions, and those are the barriers. The way you communicate is effective, is affected by the culture you are born and brought up with. The opposite is also true. Culture is also at the large extent determines the way to communicate. So it's not only taken negatively, but also taken very, very positively. The other major barrier is the psychological barrier. So let us combine the cultural and psychological barriers. Cultural is when we talk about culture, but also the psychological barrier plays a major role in communication skills. So if you have psychological barriers, they, you know, normally what is a psychological barrier? So your moods, your attitude, your perceptions, the way you take it, the mindset, everything is a barrier to your communication. So a psychological barrier of communication is the influence of the psychological state of the communicator, which creates an obstacle for the effective communication. So imagine a psychological state also can have an obstacle on your communication. So it's very important to be emotionally sound, to be mentally sound when you're talking to someone. That's called emotional intelligence. So we should know how to deal with our emotions while we are talking to people. Our emotions also should play a safe role in our daily affairs. Communication is highly influenced by the mental condition that the communicator is when it is disturbed by a mental disturbance. So suppose if I'm mentally disturbed, I had a fight at home, and I've come to work, and now I'm mentally disturbed, and now I'm going on arguing with my colleagues, with my bosses, I have an argument, I have a fight with my boss. So because I'm not mentally stable, this is called emotional intelligence. I am not intelligent enough to keep my emotions away. These are certain point, major aspects where no matter how good are you at communicating, but this will draw you back because they will lack in allowing you to communicate really, really well. Every person's mind is unique. And so the communication does not work like a machine or number. It's not a machine or it's not a mind game. It's just of how you're communicating. The person you're involved in communication matters as much as the messages. For example, if the boss does not trust you, he or she can only have selective information, which makes communication ineffective. So a boss has a mindset that he doesn't trust you. So what? But then, because he doesn't trust you, your communication is not heard the way it's supposed to be. And that's why it leads to communication ineffectiveness. Let's do the causes of psychological behavior, barriers in another video of ours. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel and stay tuned to Ekeeda.